Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to introduce a new feature called Dynamic Columns. In Analysis Workspace, you've long been able to bring in different dimensions as columns of a freeform table to create a cross-tab analysis. For example, if you wanted to look at last touch channels, trended by day, you could bring over the day dimension and drop it underneath the metric of visits. What this did in the past is it brought in the dimension items as static items, meaning they would not change over time. Now, the default behavior for Analysis Workspace will treat these as dynamic items instead. So, if you change the date range up here at the top to a new date range, the columns will change with that time as well. Clicking Apply here, you'll see that the columns changed to the word day for a second, and then they rendered the new items for this new date range. So now we're looking at May 13th through May 24th. If we picked a date range where there were less items than the columns in the table, we'll simply replace the columns that aren't available with the words unavailable. We did this rather than removing the columns altogether so as not to disrupt any downstream visualizations that might be dependent on the freeform table that was originally built. Another example of dynamic columns are with non-time dimensions. So if you wanted to look at mobile device type, for example, by last touch channel, you could bring that over to the columns as well. This is going to show you the top five marketing channels for each device type. You can tell that items are dynamic by clicking on the eye icon at the top of any column. We've now added the words top one of five, top two of five, etc. for each of the columns to tell you that these are dynamic items that may change over time. If you want any of the columns to behave statically like they have in the past, you can simply right-click and choose to make an item specific or static. What this means is as the calendar changes or the panel date range is changed, this item will remain locked. It will not change with time, and we've added a little lock icon here that's available on hover. The remaining columns will behave dynamically. So if we were to change the panel range again, and click Apply, you'll notice internal stays the same, and the other four re-render to be the top remaining items. We've also added the static lock indicator to rows as well. So for example, if you were to bring over different devices that you wanted to look at specifically, you'd find them in the left rail. We'll take these first three, drag them over, and what renders are three static rows, meaning we'll always show these specific devices. We've now added that lock icon, similar to the columns, to the rows as well, so you can clearly see when a row is locked or static versus when it's dynamic. This new functionality adds a lot more flexibility to your Analysis Workspace projects, and we hope you guys get a lot of use out of it.